You know, I think for me, like since day one on this show, like we're here to tell stories. And these stories might be different than other people's experiences, but I've found if you focus less on the details of what's happening and more on the emotional journey, you can find ways to relate. And I think that's what a lot of our fan base has done. And I know me in particular, I've had that experience with this show. That scene in particular is, of course, can be very triggering and is really difficult to watch. But, you know, it's important to note that, you know, rape victims come in different sizes and shapes and genders, and it's not always a girl who's getting assaulted. Sometimes it is a guy, and I think for us it was important to share that story and to share Tyler's story. Yeah.
I think it also just opens up a whole new conversation. Like you said, we have this idea of what a rape victim looks like, and the show really pushed against that stereotype. Yeah. And then I love that online there's resources available for people
of
if
course.
They're going through something, which is something I think they really are pushing more season two.
Yeah, I think we learned from season one that maybe we weren't, even though we had the resources available, we weren't marketing them as best as we could. And so coming into season, or at least from season one, but coming into season two, it was extremely important to have places for people to go who were feeling triggered, who, you know, watching the content felt like they needed to talk to somebody, and maybe they didn't feel comfortable talking to their parents or a counselor or a friend, and they wanted more professional help.